the cowboys. I put them in the ice cream uniforms to prove Salvo does impossible cleaning jobs. Hours from now, when those suits are filthy with sweat and ground in dirt, I'll get them clean again with Salvo power tablets.
Fruity and sure hard on clothes.
And dirty. Impossible, you say? Not for a tablet. Salvo power tablets are made to do the impossible. It takes over 100 pounds of pressure to pack all the cleaning power into Salvo so that in water, these high-pressure tablets can explode, break out power like no powder detergent possibly can. Before and after. That's the cleaning power of a tablet. Get Salvo power tablets, made to do the impossible.
Continuous 8-hour breathing relief for cold's misery. For your child, this means Vicks VapoRub.
Good evening, everyone. Len Johnson here for Carl Grayson with the late news. Topping the news at this hour, one American has been killed and another critically injured tonight in Vietnam. Albert Cardinal Meyer remains in stable condition. In sports, Montreal nibbles away at the Blackhawks National Hockey League lead. And the weatherman says more snow, 4 to 5 inches more overnight. I'll be right back with the details. First, this word for 60 seconds.
You might think the days you could get in on a good, desperate train robbery were over, but you're wrong. California. See it before it grows up. Fly out on American Airlines Royal Coachman. Most days of the week, you get a discount for your family, and you don't even have to bring the money. On American, you just pay so much a month, the way you do for a television set.
One American has been killed and another critically wounded in a double ambush by communist guerrillas on the Laotian-Vietnamese border tonight. The wounded American was accompanying a patrol. The man killed was in a second patrol sent out to rescue the first. The South Vietnamese government is reportedly seeking a negotiated settlement with North Vietnam. Meanwhile, it has been disclosed that Yugoslavia is heading up a group of non-aligned nations who are seeking a means to negotiate the South Vietnamese situation. Republican leaders in Capitol Hill say the administration should make no more trade deals with communist nations until they halt their aggression in Vietnam and elsewhere. Here's GOP House Leader Gerald Ford with the Republican policy statement.
...of bargaining. We constantly give much and get little or nothing in deals with the communist nations. We, the members of the joint Senate House Republican leadership, urge a no concession, no deal policy, meaning that the communists must be ready to make concessions as the price of agreements with the United States. Until we and our allies arrive at such a policy, we can only expect more Koreas, more Vietnams, and an ever-widening circle of communist subversion around the earth.
Commenting on the student riots against the U.S. Embassy in Moscow, Senate GOP leader Dirksen said he had counseled some caution in any U.S. reaction to the assault.
Well, I just point out, of course, that never has a stone gone through the window of the Soviet Embassy on 16th Street. Now, it does seem to me that by adequate policing, they can do something about it. But I don't go so far as to invade the authority of the country in the exercise of its domestic police power.
Russia has promised to pay for the damage done in the new attack on the United States Embassy in Moscow during the day. Foreign Minister Andrei Gromyko said that greater measures will be taken for the protection of the embassy in the future. The United States is closing all its informational activities in Indonesia because of harassment by the Indonesian government. At the same time, the Indonesian government took over control of another American rubber factory, the third in recent weeks. Here in Chicago, friends and neighbors paid their last respects today to Air Force Captain Kurt Gerice, who was killed last month in the Vietnam fighting. Funeral services for Captain Gerice were held at the Lutheran Church of St. John the Divine. Since last July, Captain Gerice had been on duty in Vietnam, training pilots and participating in airstrikes against the Viet Cong. He was killed February 24th when his plane crashed in South Vietnam. A graduate of the United States Naval Academy, Captain Gerice held the Air Medal with five oak clusters. He was born and raised in Chicago, and he attended the Naval Academy after graduation from Calumet High School. Captain Gerice is survived by his widow, Laurie, his parents, a brother, two sisters, and a daughter and son. Burial will be in Arlington National Cemetery in Washington. A 10-acre area in the community of Natchitoches, Louisiana, was flattened today when an underground natural gas pipeline exploded. In the words of a nearby resident, "I thought it was an atom bomb." 17 persons were killed, 9 of them children. The heat was so intense, it melted 6 automobiles and 3 trucks into shapeless mounds of metal. Mayor Raymond Scott tells what happened.
This thing happened about 6:04 this morning, our time, and it was a 24-inch gas line going to the Tennessee Gas and Transmission Company, of which we have a pumping station here owned by the Tennessee Gas and Transmission out of Houston. About 100 or 150 yards of line was involved, and I saw it from way across town, and it was going 300, 400, 500 feet in the air easily. And they are still working. They are still looking in these homes that have been blown down and searching in the debris for whatever they might find.
Novelist Willard Motley, a native of Chicago, is dead at the age of 52. The author died in a Mexico City hospital of a gangrene infection. Motley gained fame for his stories of life in the slums. He was best known for Knock on Any Door and Let No Man Write My Epitaph. A hearing on whether Jack Ruby will get a sanity test begins Monday in Dallas. Elmer Gertz of Chicago, one of three new Ruby lawyers, talks about the hearings.
We intend to do everything we can not to create a nuisance, because we believe in practicing law as it should be practiced. But we believe also that it's fundamental that when we have agreed to represent a client, we do everything that becomes necessary to protect his interests.
Obviously, you must feel that a sanity hearing is necessary.
Oh, yes. I think Jack Ruby was insane at the time he committed the offense. He was insane during his trial, and more so now. I don't want to enter into the evidence, but some of the evidence comes from some of the very psychiatrists who were state's witnesses at the time of the trial.
Do you think the delay in this hearing may have harmed Ruby or the case or what?
In the brief filed by Melvin Belli with Texas Court of Criminal Appeals, and it's the only brief thus far filed, he has stated, and it may very well be true, that the delay in giving proper mental therapy to Ruby has probably worsened his condition beyond repair.
In a moment, the latest report on the condition of Albert Cardinal Meyer.
gums taste good, work fast, cost less, very effective.
Doctors at Mercy Hospital say tonight that the condition of Albert Cardinal Meyer remains unchanged. Physicians say that the prelate's pulse, blood pressure, respiration, and heartbeat remain stable. He continues to breathe oxygen through a tube and is still being fed intravenously. More than 1,500 parking spaces were added to the crowded downtown area today with the opening of the new underground Grant Park South garage. Mayor Daley's limousine, leading a motorcade, broke through a symbolic paper barrier at the garage entrance. The new garage, stretching from Adams to Van Buren Streets, has a number of innovations not found in its neighbor to the north. Ramps from one level to another are not as steep. Lights in the main aisle indicate whether space is available. And parking tickets are dispensed automatically. Park District employees presented the mayor with a cake marking the 128th anniversary of Chicago. Earlier today, the Associated Retail Bakers of Greater Chicago came up with a 70-pound cake commemorating the incorporation of Chicago in 1837. The mammoth cake bore the inscription, "Proving dynamic leadership in water conservation and inland international shipping." The mayor did the honors, passing out cake to newsmen and office workers who gathered for the occasion. The remainder of the cake was sent to St. Joseph's Home for the Friendless. The subject of reapportionment came up tonight at a meeting of the Women's Bar Association of Illinois. Members of both parties debated the question of reapportionment, and the minority leader of the State House, Republican Representative Albert Hackmeister, reiterated the charge that the Democrats want an at-large election for the Senate as well as the House in 1966.
Well, I don't think there's any question at this moment, at least, from what they have evidenced in statements they have made, the kind of maps they have drawn in reapportionment, that they want to run at large. Now, I just would perhaps quarrel with the fact that they seem to feel this is going to be to their benefit. True it was in 1964, but 1966 is a different year. And I don't, quite buy this trend thing, because Harry Truman swept in a lot of people and then lost them. And this happens. Governor Stratton lost the House when he was governor. So if they want to subject the people of the state of Illinois to an at-large election, which is a very costly procedure, this is the risk they are taking. And I just don't think the people in the state of Illinois are about to buy another at-large election solely to support the political caprice of a party.
Steve Schickel of Channel 9 News then asked Democrat Daniel Doherty if it were true that his party wants an at-large election for the Senate.
That is completely untrue. We of the Democratic Party feel that we are capable, and that the legislature is capable of drawing a reapportionment map that will provide to the people of the state of Illinois adequate representation. We do not anticipate, nor do we desire, an at-large election in the Senate or the House, as far as that's concerned. The experience of the recent at-large election was so horrendous that we feel that the people of Illinois should not be subjected to that again.
A difference of opinion on reapportionment aims in Illinois. In a moment, tonight's hockey scores and the rest of the sports news.
What works best when you have a cold? The leading cold capsule or the four-way cold tablet? Both of these relieve cold miseries. The cold capsule is primarily for nasal relief. Four-way gives more than just nasal relief. In fact, the four-way cold tablet gives you cold misery relief the capsule can't give. Four-way relieves aches and pains. Four-way relieves sluggishness. And four-way relieves fever. But you do the comparing. The leading cold capsule gives primarily nasal relief. Four-way gives you nasal relief. Four-way gives you aches and pain relief. Four-way gives you sluggishness relief. Four-way gives you fever relief. When you get cold miseries, what works best? Four-way cold tablets. They work fast, too.
In the National Hockey League tonight, second place Montreal crept closer to the league-leading Chicago Blackhawks, but Toronto kept the damage to a minimum at least. The Canadiens and the Maple Leafs battled to a 2-2 tie, allowing the Canadiens to gain 1 point and creep within 2 points of the Blackhawks. In another game, the New York Rangers defeated the Boston Bruins by a score of 4-3. The Hawks rest until Saturday night, and they will play at Toronto, and Channel 9 will be telecasting that game beginning at 7 o'clock Chicago time. In college basketball tonight, St. Louis University defeated North Texas 90-73 in a Missouri Valley Conference game. The Billikens of St. Louis and another Missouri Valley team, Bradley, have been given bids to the National Invitation Tournament. This completes that 14-school field. High school as well as college basketball teams are getting into the tournament swing. Four city teams advanced to the semifinals of the Public League. In this game, Marshall in the white uniforms defeated Harlan 87-60. In other games, DeSable defeated Harper 98-58, Carver won over Crane Tech 104-98, and Dunbar defeated Tilden Tech 72-52. The four winning teams, Marshall, DeSable, Carver, and Dunbar, will draw tomorrow for opponents in the semifinals. The games themselves will be played next Tuesday at the International Amphitheater. And this viewing note, Channel 9 will telecast the Illinois High School Tournament Finals March 19th and 20th from Champaign. From spring training camps today, the White Sox announced that pitcher Joe Horlan is no longer a holdout. He arrived at Sarasota today and signed his 1965 contract for $21,000. This was reportedly the original offer. Horlan had wanted about $3,000 more, but General Manager Ed Short refused to compromise. The National League Chicago Cubs are in the throes of spring training in Mesa, Arizona. Head coach Bob Kennedy confers with other coaches on the team's prospects for the coming season. And that is Alvin Dark of the coaching staff. He was on hand to look over some of the pitching. Dick Ellsworth at the moment. The lefty, of course, one of the stalwarts of the Chicago Cub pitching staff for some time. And there is veteran Lou Burdett showing some of his old form. And pitchers Bob Buell and Larry Jackson were also on hand to pitch a few. And infielder Ron Santo runs to first base after hitting to Leo Burke. It was Burke to Ernie Banks for the putout. The batting practice, pitching practice, and the other more grueling aspects of getting in shape will continue until the season gets underway. In golf, four men are tied for the lead after the first round of the $65,000 Pensacola Open. Jack Nicklaus, Doug Sanders, Kel Nagel, and Dave Marr all shot 68s. Tied for second, one stroke down, are Billy Casper, Don Cherry, Chuck Courtney, and Billy Martindale. Arnold Palmer is tied with 14 others. He had a 71. And Gary Player and Ken Venturi are tied with 26 others at 72. Incidentally, Channel 9 will telecast the final round of the Pensacola Open this Sunday afternoon. In a moment, the official Chicago and vicinity weather forecast.
In my house, in my bathtub, was something I don't like. Bathtub ring. Mommy says, anytime soap or detergent mixes up with water and dirt, they make washing film, like bathtub ring. And if there's a ring on your tub, there's film on your clothes. I hate bathtub ring. Good thing Mommy's smart. Now she uses Calgon water conditioner. Our towels are very soft and absorb, very clean. My sister's wash and wear and our daddy's shirts are real white. Calgon gets our wash the cleanest on the block without a whole big amount of detergent neither. Saves Mommy money. If there's a ring on your tub, there's film on your clothes. Mommy gets rid of it with Calgon. I love my Mommy. The end.
Well, here it is officially for Chicago and area. Hazardous driving warning still in effect. Wet snow will cause difficult driving conditions during the night. Total accumulation by morning, 4 to 5 inches. The low will be in the low 20s. Friday's snow much of the day, but melting will prevent appreciable further accumulation. High will be in the low 30s. And then Friday night, snow flurries and a little colder, the low 15 to 20. And the outlook for Saturday, snow flurries and a little colder. Right now, it's officially 24 degrees at Midway Airport. At O'Hare Field, it's 23, and down at Tribune Tower, it's also 24. The humidity is a very high 92%. The wind right now from the southwest at 10 miles per hour. That is The Late News, a presentation of Channel 9 News, written and edited by Charles Shriver. I'm Len Johnson for Carl Grayson. Have a good night.
Double fresh flavor, double smooth too. Double mints, double delightful to chew. You love double mint gum. Get double everything rolled into one. You love double mint gum. Double good double mint gum.